On June 12, 2022, at 3:37 a.m. local time, the Bulusan Volcano in the Philippines produced a new phreatic eruption, sending a plume of ash several hundred meters into the sky. Over the next 18 minutes, the eruption continued, ejecting particles of superheated ash and pulverized rock. During this period, an interesting incandescent glow was noted to originate from Bulusan's summit, where it was seen by many from its southwestern flank. After the explosive phase of the eruption ended at 3:55 a.m., six vents, which each originated from a distinct crater on the mountain, began emitting moderate amounts of ash. These weak ash and steam plumes would later be seen once the sun rose, rising to a height of 500 meters and drifting to the north and northwest. By 9 a.m., the ash emissions had ceased, and towns up to 50 kilometers distant from the volcano had been covered in up to 3 millimeters of fresh ash. What had just occurred was the second phreatic eruption of Bulusan during its new eruptive period, which began on June 5th. So, what will happen next? Was the incandescent glow seen on Bulusan lava? How long will its new eruption last? This video will answer all three of these questions and discuss Bulusan's recent eruption. For context, Mount Bulusan is located on the southeastern tip of the island of Luzon, where it is 54 kilometers southeast of Lake Azpi. Bulusan is a more than 1,000 meter tall and acidic stratovolcano, which is one of the most active volcanoes in the Philippines. It has erupted 14 times since 1978, where each eruption consisted of a single or group of phreatic explosions, which are essentially large steam explosions. They are caused when underlying magma directly or indirectly heats overlying groundwater, causing it to flash to steam. Since the same mass of steam takes up more space than the water it once was, it causes an immense amount of pressure to build. Eventually, this pressure is released upwards in an explosive manner, producing an eruption which does not eject any lava. Since record-keeping began at Bulusan in 1852, it has not erupted a single fragment of lava. Thus, the witnessed orangish-red incandescence during Bulusan's latest eruption was not lava, but most likely a symptom of volcanic lightning. This lightning was generated when millions of ash particles collided with one another, creating an electrical current which raced outwards in several directions. The incandescence was thus likely the result of a lightning-caused vegetation fire on Bulusan's summit. Although Bulusan's edifice has been uplifted by hydrothermal fluids, there is currently no indication that a magmatic eruption is imminent, as the movement of molten rock within the volcano's magma conduit has so far not been detected. Regardless, you might be looking at Bulusan's latest eruption and be confused as to why it's currently only rated as a 1 on the 0-5 alert level system. This apparent low rating is not due to negligence, but rather has to do with how Bulusan is assigned its alert level. Not only do individual geological and disaster agencies have distinct rating systems, but also many agencies give individual volcanoes differing criteria which must be met for a raised alert level to be issued. In the case of Bulusan, phreatic eruptions without evidence of a magmatic intrusion fits the criteria to be designated as a 1, whereas the same scenario would cause Pinatubo to be designated as a 2. In the next several days to weeks, Bulusan will most likely continue to produce occasional phreatic explosions interspersed with moderate degassing of the volcano. Historically, the median eruption of this volcano has lasted 40 days, but some eruptions have lasted longer than 3 years. There really isn't a good method to determine how long an eruption will last. Based on the current emissions of Bulusan, its combined two phreatic eruptions would most likely be classified as a 2 on the 0-8 volcanic explosivity index. Bulusan's historic eruptions have ranged anywhere from a 1 to a 3, producing plumes up to 8,000 meters in height. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Amy Green, for supporting this channel.